Well, the initial stumbles of the 30th SEA Games all but forgotten as the grand opening ceremony Saturday night proved to once again be a potent reminder of Southeast Asian camaraderie through sports. But could the Philippines hosting also prove to be a boon to tourism? Joining us on the line is Jojo Clemente, president of the Tourism Congress of the Philippines. Good afternoon, sir, and thanks for joining us.
Hi, Ring. Good afternoon.
Jojo, you had earlier offered your assistance in the logistics of the SEA Games, but had been ignored, along with a Muslim organization, as consultant for Halal Foods, as well as the tourism department itself. Do you agree with pronouncements by FIS GOC that the early logistical hiccups of the SEA Games have been resolved and hopefully forgotten?
Well, to a certain degree, I think we experienced some concerns during the first few days, but moving forward, I think we have been able to address all, if not most, of the concerns. And I think we've already seen the past few days that complaints have been to a minimum or none at all already. So I think everyone is moving together now to make sure that the hosting comes off as a very successful one for the Philippines.
By how much does the SEA Games, the hosting of the SEA Games, benefit a country in terms of tourism? Can we put it in dollar terms? How much it might grow for the year or in later years?
Yeah. Well, the figures that we have so far is that the hotels will be making around $840 million pesos from the billeting alone. So that's indicative of the kind of revenues that we would be making for the entire SEA Games. And that's just for the athletes, no? So hotels, Sean. When we talk about spectators are also flying in to watch. So I think we're going to have a healthy amount as far as revenues are concerned for the tourism industry.
Now, had the Tourism Congress of the Philippines been a part of the organizing party for the SEA Games, what would we have avoided, and what would TCP and its members have gained?
Well, I think overall, coordination as far as the arrivals and maybe some of the arrangements. Although from what we understand now, some of the incidents that happened were also due to the maybe lateness of the information that was received by FISCO. So, but nevertheless, the industry, the hoteliers, the transportation companies, we adjusted on the fly. And we were able to accommodate them as best we can. No? Again, admittedly, the first few days we had some problems. But again, now I don't think we've been hearing any more concerns with regard to that. So the TCP naman, because our members are mostly the members of the tourism industry, so we help, we pitch in any way we can, like with the hotels, with the transportation, with the food. So we're working with the Department of Tourism very closely on this.
All right. Well, House Speaker and lead organizer Alan Peter Cayetano said that he hoped that the opening ceremonies would restore the spirit of the country for the SEA Games. Does it undo the opening ceremonies? Does it undo any negative perception the country may have had from the messy start? Or would it depend on the closing ceremony and, you know, the actual procedure of the games?
Yeah, I think the opening ceremony had a good effect as far as our hosting is concerned. Like I keep on mentioning, we managed to control the situation. And ranging from the comments that we've been reading from mainstream media and social media, I think most people have already have moved forward, no? And I think everyone is now really determined to make sure that the next week or so will be seamless as far as the arrangements are concerned. Of course, that's not to say that there might be some things that will arise, but we will do our best to mitigate or minimize whatever those are.
Right. Now, Jojo, do you believe that the early issues that had been proliferated by fake news and an organized political campaign against the SEA Games?
Well, that's not for me to say. I think that's more for the government to really address. I understand where both sides are coming from, but the tourism industry is supposed to be apolitical, so we're just we leave it to the government to answer that and to investigate that.
Now, Filipinos are, of course, known for their special brand of service or customer service with a smile. Are we showing that now? And do you think, what are the prospects in the coming days?
We have been showing it since day one. I mean, maybe it's not, it hasn't been evidenced by some of the incidents that happened, but we do their best. The hoteliers have also done their best to accommodate the requests, although like any event, you cannot pull things off 100% perfect. We do our best to do that, but we, from day one, the tourism industry has done its best to show the best of Philippine hospitality, and we will continue to do so for the duration of the Sea Games.
Now, there was a little controversy that arose last Friday when the FISGOC said that only accredited photographers of the FISGOC and some regional news agencies would be allowed to take photos, purportedly to avoid fake news from cropping up. Photos, of course, are part of the whole tourism experience. Would you like to offer an opinion on this?
I guess that is the prerogative of FISGOC and the government if they did that. If we had more pictures, then you know it could be a contributor to spreading good news about the Philippines. Maybe not necessarily fake news, but good news, because people tend to also show the good side of things. No, of course there will be people who will show negative aspects of something, but usually if you have good pictures, and it usually comes out as a good news or a good spin on how things are happening.
Precisely what also the NUJP had said. Now, what is the hope for the remainder of the SEA Games until the closing ceremony on December 11th? How do we push to the maximum long-term benefits from the hosting of the SEA Games?
Well, when we, as we continue hosting the SEA Games, and the more that we can address whatever concerns, or if we anticipate whatever concerns, then we hope that the athletes, the officials from the other countries, would also highlight their good experiences moving forward from whatever bad experiences there were in the beginning. And from that, we can generate some goodwill, and they will realize that everything that they've heard about the Philippines, about our hospitality, how it's more fun in the Philippines, is really true. So we're all working together, the tourism industry is working together to ensure that we show the best of what the Philippines and the Filipinos can offer.
On that note, Jojo Clemente, President, Tourism Congress of the Philippines, thank you so much for sharing your thoughts with us.
Thank you, Rain.